I'm in LA right now, working out for the draft. Right now, I'm working out with Don McLean. He just helped me with a lot of things, conditioning, and just learning how to be a point guard. The process has been amazing. Growing up was definitely difficult. It was just me and my brother on our own. My mom, she had a problem. She was going in and out of jail. We were by ourselves for like 3 months. And we had to learn how to get food on our own because we didn't have no money. I mean, my brother didn't have a job. We were too young to get jobs. We had to do things that most people want to do when they're young. We just had to. We had to survive, and it really wasn't easy for us. My brother always knew that I had a talent, but I didn't really see it. You know, I was just doing it just to get the money so, you know, we could survive. And he just told me to keep sticking with it. And me and him was going to the park every day, playing one-on-one against one another. And I mean, he teaching me some of the stuff because he was good at basketball. If I would have kept going through that path and I had nobody to, you know, watch out for me, I don't know where I would be. I didn't even know my father. I never seen my father before until that time. And it was hard for me because I don't just trust anybody right away. Once my dad came in, he put that discipline, that structure on us, and it helped us for the better. He was teaching us how to be a man. He was teaching us how to grow up and live in this world. Every day I was in the gym because I missed so much time. And I knew if I wanted to be the player that I know I could be, then I have to be in that gym day in, day out. Everybody was having the buzz and the hype that, you know, Chris was going to go to the NBA. But the whole time in my head, I knew I was going to come back. My dad, he always wanted me to graduate college. I wanted to get my college degree, not for me, but for my family, you know, for the people in New London, you know, the people who ain't have the opportunity. I just want to show them you could get through anything. That was my first full year of college basketball, so I wasn't ready to go to the NBA. On the court, I knew I wasn't physically, you know, mentally ready, and I didn't want to rush it. Be independent, you know, never be a follower, be your own person. If you're a true believer and you love the game, you can't fake it. You know what I mean? You can tell who loves the game, who doesn't. And if you believe in yourself that you could be a good player, then believe in yourself, you know, have the confidence that you can actually play with anybody on the court, and I think that's what a true believer is.